What? Patriarchy.
Yelling my point!
Vagina!
That was just the best Samantha Bee impression I could do on short notice. The leather jacket's not in yet. It wasn't on Prime. Oh, she's trending again, this time because Samantha Bee absolutely shredded Donald Trump over his abortion comments to hear HuffPo tell it. What they don't tell you in trying to make her the new anti-patriarchy heroine du jour is that nearly everything she said was wrong. Let's go to the tape.
If you were hoping to hear a debate moderator ask about climate change, you have to wait another 4 years. And I suggest you do it on higher ground.
Yeah, everyone wanted to hear a debate on climate change. Except actually, I, like most Americans with whom you're becoming increasingly out of touch, wanted to hear a debate on fiscal policy and hopefully national security. So.
Bullshit.
If you were hoping to hear old men talk about vaginas some more, hey, it's your lucky night!
No, I much prefer shrill, cackling bitches discussing vagina on primetime.
I want to explore how far you believe the right to abortion goes. You also voted against a ban on late-term partial birth abortions.
Excuse me a sec. Joe, thank you so much. Thank you. Partial birth abortions aren't a thing. Thank you.
Firstly, of course, Joe is your producer. Who'd have seen that one coming? Secondly, partial birth abortion is a thing. It's been a thing for a long time.
Come on, don't bullshit me.
A non-medical term the National Right to Life Committee made up in the 90s for a procedure that was outlawed in 2003 by the Partial Birth Abortion Ban Act.
Ah, so what she means is that partial birth abortion is really just nomenclature for a scientific term to describe the intact dilation and extraction. So you can say it isn't a thing all you want, but people watching, you may want to get small children out of the room. This is exactly what that process is like. Dilation and extraction is an abortion method involved in dilating the woman's cervix, then pulling the fetus through feet first until only the head remains inside. Using scissors and other sharp instruments, the head is then punctured, the skull compressed, so that it too can fit through the dilated cervix. So this method was coined partial birth abortion because the child was in part halfway out of the birth canal before the scissors or forceps were jammed into its head, ending its life. And by the way, it was banned in 2003. You know who fought vehemently against banning this practice? People like you and Hillary Clinton, who voted against the partial birth abortion ban.
This bill is extreme, deceptive, and unconstitutional.
Don't bullshit a bullshitter.
The Partial Birth Abortion Ban Act, seen here being signed by George W. Bush, along with some of Congress's leading women's health experts.
Oh, this is the part where we condemn white men for having an opinion on murder, but I bet you if little Beta Joe came out in support of a woman's right to choose partial birth abortion, you'd champion him, a warrior of social justice. What a brave, ballless man Joe would be.
Bullshit.
Chris Wallace conflated partial birth abortion, which doesn't exist, with late-term abortion, which does. Rarely. Only 1.3% of abortions take place at or after 21 weeks. And guess what? It's not because women are selfish sluts who wake up in their third trimester and decide, not into this, I want a procrastinated abortion.
Actually, that's often exactly what it is. That's why a vast majority of abortions are ever performed. And that's why Democrats today, like Hillary Clinton and Elizabeth Warren, still fight for abortions anytime on demand after 21 weeks. Maybe 10 years down the line, you'll be acting as though you always considered it to be the inhumane practice that it is. Just like now you are with partial birth abortion. We were kind of wrong about that, so let's just say it's not a thing. It's never been a thing.
It's 90% bullshit.
It's usually because the tests done at that point reveal a fatal birth defect or serious risk to the mother's life.
Except neither of those are true. Let's start with the term fatal birth defect. What does that mean? Does that mean a baby that would be dead on arrival, or does it mean any baby who might have a disability so the parents don't want to go through the trouble of raising that child so they select to abort it? Kind of like the statistics that came out from the Lorsier Institute that says 90% of Down syndrome babies are aborted if the parents know beforehand. Now, some people said that there was very little U.S. participation in that study, so let's take a more conservative approach, looking at British statistics showing that 53% of prenatally diagnosed children are aborted. Half of those children are aborted just because they might have a defect. Side note, even if you're cool with aborting babies because they're different or slightly disabled, often the prenatal testing is wrong, as you can see if you click here or references at lotterywithcredit.com. I want to replay the second half because it matters.
A serious risk to the mother's life.
Serious risk to the mother's life. This is what leftists use, right? Well, of course, listen, if they both are going to die, let's save one. It's a serious risk to the mother's life. How often do you hear that? Only Roe v. Wade doesn't mention life at all. Basing alleged injury on the future possibilities of contraceptive failure, pregnancy, unpreparedness for parenthood, and impairment of the wife's health. Health is very different from life. How do we define health? Anything could be filed under health, and they have, including anxiety disorders, slight irritability, or not wanting to go to prom. When they did an analysis of women who cited health for that reason, they didn't even eliminate the possibilities of women simply claiming mental health with no corroboration. Let's do some math here. Using Samantha Bee's number of only 1.5% of abortions would add up to around 13,000 abortions per year, or 35 plus per day. These are performed after 22 weeks, where the baby is significantly developed. Most people would agree with that, and it could be performed simply because the baby has a slight birth defect or the mom doesn't want to be inconvenienced by a child, which is filed under risk of health to the mother. My, what strong feminists you are.
I smell bull.
I can tell you the government has no business in the decisions that women make, and I will stand up for that right.
Two things. Hell yes.
Oh, well, the strong feminists are communicating. They travel in packs. Hillary and Samantha are on board with the government should not make decisions for women. Except for how many taxes you pay, what school you can go to, what kind of health insurance you must buy, what kind of car you can drive, and even what kind of car gives you a lift. That's right, the strong women who fought for your right to jam forceps in a baby's head when it was halfway out the birth canal because of freedom don't even want you to have the right to use an Uber. I want to run an Airbnb. That's not fair because I'm paid off by the unions and you could take business from the hotel industry. Well, I'll just call it an abortion clinic. Oh, right this way.
Everything that guy just says, bullshit. Thank you.
Listen, you don't even have to be pro-life. I know that many of you watching this video are not. But what should affect any and all Americans is this insult to your intelligence. Let's not pretend for a second that leftists have been at the forefront of treating babies humanely, regardless of era, or that they care about your freedom. Funny enough, abortion is virtually the only area where leftists hide behind the freedom card. We're so used to them slapping down the racist, sexist, or xenophobic card, we don't even know what to do with it. So let's assume for a second that partial birth abortions, which are a thing, or late-term abortions, which are performed because the baby has a disability or the mother finds it inconvenient, is really about freedom. Let's assume that. So then why doesn't that same concept of freedom apply to the American taxpayer who doesn't want to pay for that procedure? Freedom for you to make the choice, Samantha Bee, but what about freedom for me to not have to subsidize your choice?
Oh, see, that's where freedom gets a little tricky.
So even if you don't think leftists are heartless bastards through fighting against partial birth abortion and fighting for late-term abortion, at the very least, you should find them mildly annoying because they're pickpocketing the rest of us to pay for your freedom. If you like this video, you might be an insane person. I'm glad I made this video, but it's certainly not an easy watch. You know what's an easier watch? Mystery Box. Click that. That will quell your pain, or subscribe by hitting the subscribe button below. Go to lotterywithcrowder.com for references and sources by clicking my face, or there's another secret. There's a mystery box, but there's another video playing in a box on top of it or below. I don't know. We'll put it in post.